हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज केमिस्ट्री क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर 2, फिजिकल एंड केमिकल चेंजेस. बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द चैप्टर, फर्स्ट सी व्हाट इज चेंज. चेंज इज अ कंटिन्यूअस प्रोसेस एंड ऑल्सो इट्स अ नेचुरल फेनोमेनन. Whatever the substances you see in your surrounding, whether it's living or non-living, all substances undergo change. In this context, some changes are noticeable, some are so slow that you cannot notice them or even you cannot identify them. But still changes occur. And change taking place around us continuously. So, change is the transformation of a substance from one form to another form. Transformation means any type of alteration in its properties, whether it's physical or chemical. Means any type of alteration in the physical properties and the chemical properties of a substance is called a change. The changes which you see in your surrounding that can be categorized into different categories, that can be slow and fast, natural and man-made, periodic and non-periodic, reversible and irreversible. First, see slow change. The change which takes place in a long period of time are called slow change. For an example, rotation of earth which causes day to night, formation of curd from milk, rusting of iron, all these are an example of slow change because all these changes take some time to take place. Next is fast change. The change which takes place in a short period of time are called fast change. Example, burning of paper, burning of candle, lighting of an electric bulb, etc. All these are fast change. Means all these occur in a short span of time. Next is natural and man-made change. First see natural change. The change which takes place in nature by themselves are called natural change. Example, change of day and night, earthquake, volcano eruptions, growing of a tree. All these are natural change. Means all these changes doesn't require any human effort. Whereas man-made change is a change that occurs due to the effort of human being. It's called man-made change. Example, cooking of food, formation of steel from iron, jewelry from gold, etc. All these need human effort. So all these are man-made changes. Next is periodic and non-periodic change. First, see students, what is periodic change? Changes that are repeated at regular intervals of time are called periodic changes. Example, change of day and night, change of seasons, occurrence of full moon and new moon, etc. Next, non-periodic change. Changes that are not repeated at regular intervals of time are called non-periodic change. Example, landslide, earthquake, a person is becoming sick. All these are examples of non-periodic change. The next is reversible change. When a change in a substance can be reversed by changing the conditions is said to be reversible change. For an example, conversion of water into ice and conversion of ice into water is called a reversible change. Water is converted into ice during cooling process and ice is converted into water during heating process. In this complete process, there is no change occurs in the properties of water. That's why it's a reversible change. Next, irreversible change. If a substance cannot be brought back to its original state after a change, it is said to be an irreversible change. For an example, baking of a cake, metal rusting, frying an egg, burning paper, mixing mortar means mixing cement. All these are irreversible change because if we will take an example of baking a cake, once the cake is baked, after making some changes in the conditions, you cannot reverse back, means you cannot get back your original substance. So all these are irreversible change. Today's homework, what is change? Question number 2, explain different types of changes with examples. Question number 3, how can you say melting of ice into water is a reversible change? Question number 4, rusting of iron is a slow change. Give reasons. Write these answers in your chemistry notebook. Thank you.